Greetings, folks. Welcome back. I'm filming Venus here, or Ison. Anyway, these two are just beneath the moon. And I definitely think one is Venus. The one, let's say this one, I'm sure this one is Venus, the small one. Yeah, which I'll try and zoom up a bit. And it's actually in the same position of a bright early star. So let's see if we can get a closer look. That is Venus, and if I zoom out, you'll see there's another bright object right in front of it, which is an early morning star. And because they're so close together, it is easily mistaken for Venus. But as I say, Venus is just a little bit beyond this one. So now we come back to the question. Well, if it's not Venus, it could be Mercury, I suppose, or Mars. But technically, I think this one is too bright and too big to be our Venus. As you can see how it is, it's more like a sun. Okay, let me zoom back out. And we still got a new moon. This one is a follow-up to the one I posted previously. This is the same bright star, just that it's a bit lower down in the west. Alright, so I'll zoom back out now. And we'll see, as I said, it's right in front of Venus. So you can see the two of them here now. Now I think this one would fit more Venus, if the size is correct, the colors, and very far away. Steady, can't get no steady, but that one I think is Venus. Right, so what I'll do now, I'll zoom back out so you can see the proximity between the two stars. Or one star and something else. Okay, should be coming into view right about now. There it is. So that's the two of them there, Venus and, well, I'll leave a question mark for now. And if I go a bit further up, you'll see where the moon is. So the brightest one, I can't say for sure if it's Venus, but I know Venus is in the area beneath the full moon. Okay, we'll stop with the moon for a little bit. It's moving a bit too fast. Well, that's all I can say for now. So I'm going back to check with the Larium and see where the other aligning planet should be. Okay, I'll make this 4 minutes and then call it at night. Even so, that bright star, you can see it's very cloudy, and even that the moon was covered, we can see the bright star. So that means it's brighter than the moon as it is, or the cloud around the moon at that time was much thicker. Right, let's go down again now. Well, we'll go by luminance. The moon, you can see, is very bright, and it's almost as bright as this one here. You can see it's descending very low now. And you can see Venus there. That's how Venus is supposed to look in comparison with our moon. So let me just zoom out to make sure it's not a UFO. Okay, perfectly still. So this is either a falling comet or... That's it there, folks. Oh, it's moving very fast as well. Center it a bit. It's very far away. Anyway, due to the size of Venus and the distance it's away from the Earth, I would say this is more like Venus than a very, very bright star, which is now in view. Let's try and get them as big as bottom, one at the top. The one at the top, I would say Venus, one at the bottom. Well, you can't have two Venuses. And the one that is too bright. Okay, let's have a look at our Venus again. You can see it's fading away. One thing for sure, one of them is Venus.
Okay,
gone over the 5 minute now, so I'll try and capture all of them. Well, the one in the middle disappear because I say it's too far out, and you can see now our bright star is turning reddish bluish. Obviously looks like about 3 or 4 objects in one. Right, our Venus is gone. Or maybe it was another meteor just falling. You can see, you can't see the other one around there now. Oh, there it is. It's even got closer. Okay, let's watch them both. Alright, you can see that now. Well, when I convert it, maybe you'll see a bit better, but the one at the top is kind of reddish, bluish, looks like 3 different colors in one, whereas you can see the bright, bright one at the bottom, now it's just one color. Yeah, look, it's turning bluish, flashing. Okay, 7 minutes, too much. So, see you next time. Bye for now.